When I wake up, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try and book a COVID test for two. Get the phone out, I get through eventually, and they told me there's no test site next to you. I can book one for you up in Aberdeen, and you must drive there without stopping for the loo. And if I waver, hey, I know I'm gonna be the man who gives COVID to you. So I will drive 500 miles and back again 500 more. In the name of God, can someone tell me why there's no test sign next door? Johnson is so dumb. Someone pull him out to the crack of Cummings' bum. In Perugia, there's a rumour going round that Bojo popped in his private plane, allegedly. Or has he fooled you? Pulled the wool over your eyes? Has this shaggy dog told porkies once again? Dido Harding, who's the queen of cocking up? Like when Tok Tok, she has cock-ticked up again. Please forgive me if I don't get out and play on this nearby handy lady's violin. While you all drive 500 miles to find a COVID testing site, so Barnard Castle is near Twin with right down on the Isle of Wight. Da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da. Stop saying it's done by the NHS. Da-da-da-da, 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 da-da-da-da. It's called Circle and it's private trace and test.
I, for one, will not be partaking of the late-night bars in the Commons. I merely use them for late-night refreshments. After all, where else is a hard-working cabinet minister to score his coke?
Salutations, subjects. It is wonderful to be talking to you today from one's humble little gaff here in Windsor. Wherever you are watching, whether it be on the visual wireless or coming right at you down the interwebby thing on one tube. Now, as some of you may know, one has just recently received something called a Baylite. Thank heavens for that. But as you can imagine, for a billionaire like oneself, it really isn't enough. So one needs your help. Why does one of the richest women in the world need a bailout, one hears you cry? Well, for one, bail is exactly what one is going to need when Andrew rocks up to testify in a New York courtroom. And those nurses looking after Philippe don't whip themselves, you know. In the former colonies, Harry and his Wallace Simpson strumpet have long been a cause of great sorrow. So if you could spare a few mil, or even a cartload of gold bars, that would just about stop one from letting Philippe get the Fiat Uno out of the garage for one last job. The corgis have started biting lumps out of each other as they are being starved of their favourite food of poached pheasant. And no, one didn't mispronounce the word pheasant. So please give generously, or one will release Cliff and Gary Barlow to do a charity single, and nobody wants that. So please give what you can, and help the yachtless by donating to one's crowdfunder. One thanks you all, and may all your taxes go with me.
Hi, Sakia. Oh. Hi, yeah, I'm here to help you with your new slogan. Yeah, you may know some of my work. You know, stay at home, protect the NHS, save lives.
Well, but everyone's out. The NHS is still underfunded and oversubscribed, and thousands of people have died.
There's no need to stress over detail.
I was thinking maybe something like just do it, but let's do it. No. Rishi's using that one next month. He's very keen on sexual innuendo after the success of Eat Ike to help out. Maybe you'd like something more like my other slogans, you know, like stay alert, control the virus, save lives.
Well, the thing about that, you see, is you can't see the virus, and you certainly can't train it to behave with biscuits, and still, you know, thousands dead.
Yeah, right. All right then, Mr. Expert. I suppose you've got a better idea.
I like rhyming. How about Kier's here?
Doesn't actually rhyme, though, does it?
What about Starmer's karma?
See, generating a rhyming slogan, you need to keep it simple. Like, you know, my latest, you know, hands, face, space.
Hands doesn't actually rhyme with face or space?
Well, it wasn't designed to rhyme. They just wouldn't let me keep the rest of it. It was supposed to be hands, face, space, head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
What about at least I'm not Corbyn?
I love it! Oh!
Hello, it's me, scientific sex god, Brian Cox. Wow. Life on Venus, is it possible? Or even desirable? The second closest planet to the Sun, Venus is inhospitable, with a surface temperature around 867 degrees Fahrenheit and pressure 92 times that of Earth. However, 33 to 38 miles above, we've recently discovered traces of phosphine gas in these sulfuric acidy clouds. Yes, wow. You see, on Earth, phosphine gas is produced naturally by bacteria or results from the decaying of organic matter. So the presence of this gas indicates the planet may support living organisms floating in the clouds above Venus. Wow. Good news for those who fancy getting away from it all. Why not spend some time in a highly acidic cloud swirling high above an inhospitable planet with a smell akin to garlic and rotting fish for company? After all, after what's gone in 2020, that sounds quite inviting, actually. Wow.
Captain Dido Harding, at your service.
Well, of course, I think I'm doing a fantastic job, yes. It's just that I didn't anticipate that the sea near the North Pole would contain any icebergs. As I said to our navigator, Seaman Grayling, sail on till sunset. Or was it Man the Lifeboats? One of those, anyway. So, bugged Grayling $100,000 a year for 2 minutes' work, anyway. Anyway, did I tell you what a fantastic job I'm doing? Yes, jolly hockey sticks. Oops.
My fellow white Americans, the Donald here, so great. I'll give you my full title, Donald J. Trump. What does the J stand for? Genius, so great. Now, I admit it, it's a total scandal. I only paid $750 in tax, but I also paid $70,000 for my hair consultant. It's a total scandal. I demand a refund.
Down here in the great state of Texas, we ain't scared of this so-called brain-eating amoeba in our here water supply. Why, most of us Texans ain't got no brains for it to be eaten anyhow. Yee-haw! Ain't that right?
Listen to this.
Spy on me, neighbor, if you like. There's no one coming round here. Now I always thought that we were tight. Now look at you, we're picking a fight.
I hate it when we fight.
Don't you think I know that I'm allowed no more than 5 friends who might be coming round? Well, I got nothing to hide or right. Quit giving me the evil eye. Six tops, the rule six tops. No more than 2 households and I know is a lot. Six tops, the rule six tops. Don't grass your neighbors to cops.
Don't dump them in. It's getting like the Stasi around here.
Now don't get me wrong, it don't mean no offense. The rules are so confusing and they don't make sense. Could have up to 34 hunting grouse, but only 6 inside the house, and I'm not hunting grouse. So stop making those curtains twitch, or are you just a stuck-up nosy little snitch? Now wait a minute, I've just had a thought. Are you meant to count your kids or not? 6 tops, 6 tops, the rule 6 tops. No more than 2 households, and I know that is a lot. 6 tops, 6 tops, the rule 6 tops. Don't grass your neighbors to the cops. Don't dump them in. Stop twitching those curtains, baby.
You're watching Fox News with me, Ann Anker. The political world is in turmoil following the death of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. For more on this, let's go over to the White House and our reporter on the spot, Chad Vallée. Hi, Chad.
Hi, Ann.
What was Joe Biden's reaction to the passing of Ginsburg, Chad?
He was distraught, Ann. He said he'd been a big fan of Ginsburg for many years, and as a boy, he'd even bought a copy of her Howl poems.
And how about Donald Trump, Chad? What were our beloved Führer's thoughts on her passing?
He was upset, Anne, but he made it clear he clashed with Ginsburg many times over their differences concerning the Supreme Court.
Would that be because she was a passionate defender of the rights of the individual and freedom and equality for all?
No, Anne, that would be because Trump wanted to change the court's name to the White Supremacy Court.
Thanks, Chad. You've been watching Fox News, and I've been Ann Anker. Good night.
Can I help you? How?
Brighton Council, is it?
How?
A little bird told us that you was in need of some help to make sure people are sticking to the coronavirus rules. So my associate and I have come down from the smoke to help out.
Oh, I don't really think that's necessary.
Nice local authority you've got here. Be a shame if something were to happen to it. Yeah, we just want to make sure that people are abiding by the government regulations, don't we? Yeah. Imagine what would happen if you didn't have a couple of nice experienced COVID marshals. People meeting groups of more than 6, no masks, you'd be in right barley rubble.
How? It's all right, I think we can handle it ourselves.
Don't think you understand. If you hire us, nothing's going to happen. But if you don't hire us, we can guarantee that things are going to get very messy. Very messy.
What is outrageous? It's a protection racket, that's what this is. I am calling the Department of Health.
You misunderstand. No, we are the Department of Health.
But the threats?
Threats? All we said was if you don't pay COVID marshals, it'll be carnage, because no one will adhere to government regulations. We're supposed to keep them safe.
How? Well, I suppose you did, actually. All right, maybe you're right, OK. But the council will pay you for your COVID marshalling services. God knows you've got no manpower to spare. How?
Lovely doing business with you. It's all right, mate. It's just our cheeky cockney manner that scrambled you.
Did you used to work in the arts? Fed up with having no job, no money and no viable skills? Then why not retrain as a Tory cabinet minister? Earn shed loads of dosh for doing, well, not very much at all, really. We'll give you complete training. How to blame firefighters, care home workers, immigrants. We'll show you how to take money from the poor, the disabled, the NHS, and give contracts to all of your friends. Apply today. And don't worry, if he really pulls up on the job, we'll just get you a job advising the ports for 100 grand a year for 2 minutes work. Or, better still, promote you to head up MI5.
Jemima!
Jocasta!
Mwah! Mwah! Oh, it's been so long. How have you been?
Oh, well, obviously, you know, as soon as the whole lockdown thing started, we went straight into hiding.
Oh, only then? Oh, right, well, we anticipated the whole thing. We've been isolating since Christmas.
Well, when I say when it started, I mean that we know when the market in Wuhan was built, so, you know, 1985.
Well, we started isolating the first time anyone coughed within a 5-mile radius. We only left the house in zorbs.
So how's it going with homeschooling?
Oh, absolutely fantastic.
Natch.
Yeah, my Tarquin's now fluent in 3 languages, and we're only now realising the full potential. Honestly, teachers are so lazy. Tell me about it. Mooncup's got so bored with the essays they've said, she switched to writing them in hieroglyphics just for a change.
Yeah, but the social aspect of school is so important.
Oh, yeah, totes, yeah. Yeah, we try to recreate the experience as much as possible. Yeah. We got a neighbour's child to bully them through the hedgerow.
Oh, right. We've installed life-size student cutouts around the living room with iPads strapped on to create the ambient playground feel. Yeah.
And our architect has just finished off a replica bike shed for our garden that I'm going to get pregnant behind next week. Well, our eldest goes to a Catholic school, so we've linked him up with our local priest, but buggery just isn't the same via Zoom.
There's no beating the real thing.
Oh, no, we do the beatings. But it's been so nice, you know, having quality family time. Oh, yeah. My hubby, Austin, has been working from home and has turned our basement into a gym for couples tantric yoga.
Yeah. Pericles and I have never been closer.
We're starting our own relationship podcast series next week to help those more intimately challenged. Oh, and then our guru's going to renew our wedding vows at a socially distanced ancient ritual where we all wear togas and sacrifice an avocado.
Well, I can't be Zooming you all day. I've got to go and make my vegetable stew, made solely from ingredients grown in my garden during lockdown.
and I'm going to have to talk terms with my publisher over the novel I wrote while shielding. Oh, and then, of course, there's the online nuclear fusion course I'm taking. Must get that done before I help Mooncup finish her loom band-based recreation of the bio-tapestry.
Ciao.
Yes, to a gin. Make it a double.
Well, I don't know, do I? I just stick it in front of CBeebies like we always do.
Ooh.
Settle down, everyone.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, Scotland made the wearing of face masks mandatory in public last week.
The UK government are making the wearing of face masks mandatory in public next week.
As I was saying, Scotland will also be providing a relief fund specifically for theatres and the arts to help them through this difficult period.
Anyway, as I was saying, the UK will be providing a relief fund specifically for theatres and the arts to help them through this difficult period.
Anyway, we will also be extending free school meals throughout the winter. Right, I've had about enough of this. Stop it.
I've had about enough of this. Stop it.
Seriously. Knock it off. Stop copying me.
Seriously, knock it off. Stop copying me.
This is so childish, Boris. Stop copying.
This is so childish, Boris. Stop copying.
Scotland is an independent country.
Scotland is an independent country.
At the very start of the month of September, in the first year of the decade where everything had gone wrong, the human race encountered another threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places. Thank you.
Online shop, online shop of horrors, Amazon. Online shop of terror, gotta stop. Online shop of horror, no, oh, oh, no. Posting seeds that nobody ordered, Chinese seeds. So you gotta warn them, oh, these weeds could wreck the ecosystem, no, oh, oh, no. Chandeliers, now they're banning sales outside the US. Shang-a-lang, it happened in Scotland too. Sha-la-la, stop our way, why don't you post a thing? You better, telling you, you better not let those, or something's gonna get ya.
Feed me, seed boy.
Online shop, online shop of horrors, Amazon. Online shop of terror, gotta stop. Online shop of horror, no, oh, oh.